Hi everyone, Simona here from Vector Twist. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a glowing city tower. I always like to work with transparencies and glows in Illustrator, and I want to share the tips and tricks I have learned over the years with you. So the first thing I usually do, I set up my layers. I already created my first layer for the background, and then we're going to add all of the other layers that we need for this design. It's really beneficial to do that. Now I've already created the background, I'm just going to show you what this looks like. So I'm going to turn it on. I've used the gradient tool in Illustrator, and if I go and open it up, make sure to bring the fill to the front so you can edit it, I've been using the freeform gradient. Now all I've done here is added several points and then gave them a color. If I'm going to double click, you'll see all of the colors that we have here in this Illustrator file. You can download the file so you have the exact same colors and follow along with this tutorial. Now back to our layers, and I'm going to lock it, and then we're going to start adding the pieces one by one. Since we're going to create the isometric perspective for this tower, we're going to be working with the ellipse tool, and then one by one I'm going to build up the tower, the base, and everything else. So of course, to make things faster, I'm going to use the isometric actions and then simply going to create a circle and then turn it into the tower. Once you have your shape, you can just use the shape builder tool and then merge them together. The only thing we need to cut out is this top part, so I'm going to create a copy of my top shape for my tower, and then I'm simply going to use the shape builder tool again and then delete the parts that I don't need. Right away we want to add a gradient shape to our tower. So just apply one of the regular gradients from Illustrator, and then we're going to change the colors. And then I'm going to add a stop right into the middle. Select at the same time the stop on the other side and push it in a little bit. Now we're going to change the colors, and then we're also going to make sure that we're going to change the opacity setting for each and every single gradient slider stop. So the last one is going to be 0%, the one in the middle is going to be 30%, and then the one on the other side is going to be 50%. All we have to do now is move the shape on top of the other one, and we can select all of it and then align it properly. The next step is to create the base for the tower, and since we need similar elements, I'm just going to copy them onto the other layer. So all you have to do is select the shape, press the Option or Alt key, hold it, and then drag the shape down onto the layer below. Once that's done, I'm going to select it and increase it slightly, so it's just a little bit bigger than our base tower, and move it to the bottom. Next, we're going to create a copy of this, push it to the bottom, select both of the shapes, and then with the Pathfinder, we're going to divide it. Going to ungroup everything, and then select the top shape, merge them back together with the Unite in the Pathfinder, and then the bottom part, we can give a freeform gradient. So let's zoom in, and let's add that right away. So all you have to do is open up your gradient panel, and then switch to the freeform gradient, and then we can start adding our points. One by one, I'm going to assign new colors to it, and then we have the colors for our base shape. Now, since we're already working on the bottom, let's switch layers again, and let's add the shadow for the base. We need to create a copy again of the base, top circle, so select it and then drag it onto your new layer. We're going to push it to the bottom and then change the color right away. And then I'm simply going to apply a feather effect. So all the way up to Effect, Stylize, and choose Feather. Put a value of 65 pixels, and then we're going to increase our base shape. Now we can be working on the top shape for our tower. So drag a copy onto the appropriate layer, and then the top base we're going to shrink down so we have the same size as the tower. Then we can continue with the next shape. Create another copy, but I'm going to delete the outer shape, and then the top shape I'm going to shrink down, and I'm going to again be working with a freeform gradient. So back to the gradient panel, click freeform gradient, and then we're going to add our stops. This time I'm going to have 6 stops, 2 on the left, 2 in the middle, and 2 on the right. Since I already created a group for the colors, I'm going to add the colors to the points. Once that's done, we're going to create a copy into the back, and we're giving it a dark red again, and it's going to be a little bit thicker than the other shapes that we've created, so I need to actually add a rectangle to make it look like it's closed. Now right away, since we're working on the top, we're going to add another shadow. Same effect, we're going to be using the feather effect again. To make our life easier, I'm going to select the shape from the bottom and drag it onto my layer called top shadow. Then we have to select it and then move it to the top. And of course, we have to shrink it down. So we're going to shrink it down probably to this size, We'll open up the appearance panel. We'll double click the feather effect and of course decrease the radius. 15 pixels, looks pretty good. And let's move on to the other parts. Since we're still working on the top, let's zoom in and we're going to create as if light would come out of the tower. We need the same dimension as our main tower, so we can actually create a copy of the gradient shape that we have on top of our tower. And all we have to do is make sure we put it on the proper layer. And there, all we have to do is change the size. We're going to be working with the same gradient. All we have to do is change the angle from 0 into 90 degrees, and then activate the gradient annotator, and then push it all the way down a little bit. Then you can just drag the other parts into the position until you're happy with the glow. I think that looks pretty good. Again, the last gradient slider is set to 0% opacity in white, the middle one to 30%, and the red one on the bottom to 50%. So we have some kind of color on the bottom, and when I adjust it, you'll see the color is coming closer, or I can push it a little bit further out. The next part is really fun. We're going to create our glow lines that we're going to turn into like some kind of illusion of windows for our tower. So let me zoom out, and then we're simply going to create some lines. Again, we need the shapes from our tower, so let's create some copies. It really doesn't matter what shape you use, all we need is the front shape here. Create a copy onto the appropriate layer, and then we'll drag it to the side. We need to cut it in pieces. Now we can take apart our pieces. You see I cut them. I'm going to push my lines from the top and the bottom, and then the outside lines we're going to change as well. Instead of a solid color, we're going to apply a gradient. So back to the gradient panel. You can apply any gradient, so let's apply the last one, and then we're going to alter it. The first stop is going to be white, so let's switch it to white, and let's set it to 30% instead of 50. This is going to be 100%. Create a copy of it, but set it then to 70%, and then the last one is going to be only 10%. So instead of 0, we're going to switch it to 10, push it all the way to the outside. And then we need to change the angle from 0 to 90 degrees. Then we're going to be working with the width tool. Stretch it out on the bottom and make sure it's the thinnest on the top. Switch to cap round and corner round. Now before we do the next step, create a copy on the side. We're going to be using this piece later on again. The curved pieces, and we're going to change the color. We need one of the curved shapes, so create a copy as well, and then keep it for later. So this I'm going to be pushing in a little bit, create a copy onto the other side, and then we're simply going to select both of the lines and apply a blend. And then we're going to double click the blend tool, and we're going to set specified steps, maybe 6 altogether, and then press OK. Now you'll notice that it's not curved on the bottom. This is where we can actually make use of our curved shape. So just place it onto the bottom, then select the blend shape on top of it. Then we're going to go to Object and we're going to change the spine. And now you can see we have it all curved. Now the other two curved lines we're going to select as well and then create another blend. Now we can group both shapes together and then move it onto our tower and see what this looks like. I think that looks pretty neat. For the bottom, we're going to create the same. We're just going to create 3 lines. Then we're going to select the lines and then add a gradient for the stroke. Make sure it's set to the angle 0%. And then with the width tool, we're just going to drag them out a little bit in the middle. Once that's done, you can grab them, group them, and then put them on the bottom. Remember the line we've created? We're going to drag it onto the top, make it a little bit shorter. Then I can grab my line again and then create a copy on each side. Just make sure that I make it a little bit shorter so it looks just a little bit more dynamic. In the next step, we're going to create our spheres. So create a circle, then we're going to alter the gradient. We only need 2 stops. The first stop we're going to have at 100% white, the second at 30%. And of course, switch to the radial gradient. Then create a copy onto the bottom and set it behind. We're going to add another gradient. This time we're going to have 3 stops. We're going to be switching to the linear gradient, and then we're going to switch it to a much lighter color, and the other one to a much lighter color as well. Move the bottom shape up closer to your top circle, and then we can move it closer to our lines. I'm just going to create a few more copies, maybe one here in the middle and one on the other side, and that's pretty much it. And here we go, we created a glowing city tower. I would also like to thank all of the nice and amazing people that follow the VectorTwist channel and wanted this tutorial to be made. Without your support, this channel wouldn't exist. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in my next tutorial. Until then, keep creating.